Molly's here, so we're ready.
Okay, we're ready. All right. Thanks for tuning in to the second VegDisney podcast. We got back how many weeks ago now?
Well, who are you?
Oh, I'm Katie.
And I'm Sean.
And Molly's not going to say anything.
Yeah, she probably
Molly's
won't say anything.
Molly's the cat. Okay.
So, when we last left off, we were days before leaving.
Don't sniff the mic.
It might pick up some cute purring if we rub her a bunch. We were days away from leaving.
Yes. Oh, no, Molly. She wants to love the microphone. And we went, and do you want to talk about your problem?
I had a problem related to diverticulitis. So the food was good, but the eating of food, I didn't really have much of an appetite. And I was just constantly worried that something was going to set it off again.
Yeah.
So,
we
still ate a bunch, and it was good. So right. That's really all that matters now.
Right. Because he had an episode, like, what, 2 days before we were flying?
3 days?
Something like that. And then, oh, God, here she comes again.
You're not jumping from over there, are you?
Sorry, cat interruptions.
We could not anticipate feline complications.
Right. So, what we ended up doing is the first day we were there, we were going to meet a friend in Disney Springs. We dropped our stuff off. It was, I think we got down to Disney Springs around noon-ish, 11-ish, noon-ish, between 11 and noon.
Yeah.
And it was warm that day, warm and sunny. And then we found out our friend had the wrong day off, so he wasn't going to make it. And you weren't feeling good. So we went to Cooks of Dublin. We got garlic and Parmesan.
We got our standby, skinny
chips.
Our usual.
That's what we usually get.
Other people insist on Dole Whips. Ours is...
skinny chips,
yeah.
At
Cooks of Dublin.
So we got that, and we snacked on that for a bit, and we packed it up, took it with us, because, like, even sharing it was way too much
food.
Yeah,
especially for the way I was feeling.
Right.
Did you have notes?
Did you have notes.
Did you have it somewhere?
I wrote down, well, Sean thought ahead, and he wrote down everything we ate each day on a piece of paper.
On our little complimentary pad of paper and pencil.
Right, that says Walt Disney World on it.
Yeah.
And for some
Because I figured the way I felt and us running around and doing everything, we would never remember to write now at this point, which is 2 weeks after we came back, what we ate. I don't know. I probably ate some food.
Right.
That's about as detailed as I could get, so.
We had a Mickey ice cream bar. I remember that.
Yeah. For the sake of the podcast, I wanted to make sure we kept track of it.
I was glad you were thoughtful about that, because I was just like, oh, surely I'll remember.
You're way better at remembering what food we've eaten than I am.
Yeah, but you were thoughtful enough to write it down.
I'd be like, what did we eat last Tuesday for dinner? And the best I could come up with is, like, probably some recipe we made.
Right.
Or maybe a frozen pizza. I don't know.
Yeah.
So...
So we realized that our friend wasn't going to be coming. Sean didn't feel good. We went back to the resort and hung out. And then we went back later around dusk, I guess.
Yeah, back to Disney Springs for our first reservation.
Mm-hmm. We had an ADR at Raglan Road.
Which is right around the corner from Cooks of Dublin. Kind of almost attached. And I'm sure they're attached, but you can't walk in between them.
Right, that's true. But we'd never been there before, and I'd heard a lot of good things about it, and they had some vegetarian stuff, so we decided to go there.
Yeah.
In the future, if we went, I would want to go at lunchtime.
Yeah.
Like, first thing, because it was, even though we had an ADR, it was, what, like an hour?
Yeah.
It was still,
hanging
like,
out with the little beeper.
Right, and it was so crowded, and,
And very loud. I don't really care about the stage show.
And all the dancing and the music.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Yeah, or we could have at least maybe sat a little farther away.
Right. With him not feeling good, you know, we couldn't hear each other, even though we were like right across a small table.
Yeah.
And yeah.
Couldn't hear the waitress that great either. Like, is it okay? You said vegetarian.
Yeah.
No, I said pescatarian. No, 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 no.
No, no, no. Not the same.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so, and the service was a little slow because of it and, you know, all that sort of thing.
Right, having to navigate around dancing.
Right, right.
Always slows things down.
And those groups of, like, middle-aged parents without children, I assume, drinking at the bar. Like, being totally in everyone's way.
Yeah.
Yes, Molly, we're talking out loud. But the food was really good.
Yeah.
The food was great.
We had...
Go ahead.
Garden pea risotto.
Yeah, I think we had exactly what we were talking about. You had the raglan risotto.
Okay.
We'll go back
and listen to what...
Right. But it was really good. So when
I thought we were still going to list everything.
Oh, no, we are.
Okay.
But I had the tart art, and which is an asparagus and goat cheese tart with garden peas, leeks, lemon oil, dressed arugula. So it did have arugula. I don't think there was anything on it. Molly, don't get mad because I'm speaking aloud. Oh, God. Oh. She bit me.
Get down.
She gets mad when we speak too much or if I laugh.
She gets mad when you talk.
Yeah.
And then she has to bite you.
I don't know why she gets mad about that. But anyway, the arugula didn't seem to have anything on it, and I can't expect them to have the tart completely fresh. It's like a baked tart, so it was kind of getting cold as it arrived. And since it was an appetizer, she said, well, you could get another side. And we could, call that an entree since we had the dining plan. So yeah. I also got our gratin potatoes, which were amazing.
Right. We should have just ordered two au gratin potatoes.
They were so good. They came out in a really tiny
skillet,
Yeah, like a cast iron skillet. And they were just so cheesy and probably like a bazillion million calories.
Oh, she bit me. Ow, she bit me. Ow. God, I'm scared. Ah!
Really?
Molly, really? Get down. Goodness. We're suffering for this podcast.
I don't know why she gets so angry about that.
Molly. She's feeling better. She's got her weight up a little bit. She's throwing her weight around.
I guess.
I don't have to put up with your guys yammering.
Shouldn't break the skin, but that hurt.
Okay. All right, so au gratin potatoes. This is real good.
Really good. Your risotto was really good, too.
Oh, yeah. It was like a big, wide plate of just, like, risotto and peas and...
Big pieces of mozzarella.
Yeah. Oh, right, yeah.
What was the pecorino? It was like
was
a hard
cheese.
Yeah. It was really good. I ate some of his.
Yeah, I didn't eat hardly half of it, though. I felt really bad.
It's a lot of food, though.
It was, especially with the side.
Yeah.
With the potatoes that were way better.
So, yeah, it was all really good, but, in the future, I would want to go lunchtime.
No, you're not allowed up here
Get
anymore.
Get out of here, cat. Molly.
It's going to end up biting our ankles.
Monster.
All right.
Okay, so then...
official, day one.
Yeah, first day with park tickets. I can't remember how you were feeling.
Slightly better, because it was the first day we had our... we ate at Pepper Market at Coronado Springs, where we stayed. And I was like, oh man, these Mickey-shaped waffles are good.
Yeah, we shared it.
Yeah, we had... so there were like four little... Mickey-shaped Belgian waffles and a side of potatoes, because they immediately asked, what meat? We said, no meat.
And they said, how about potatoes? So, and they were good.
That became the standard. That was like 3 days? 2 days of doing
that. Something like that, yeah.
So that was really good for just, generic old Belgian waffles.
Yeah, the Pepper Market's really cool. It's really cold.
Yeah, well, at that time of year, sure.
Yeah, it was really cold in there, like no matter where you sat.
Like at the other resorts, it's the cafeteria style.
Right.
Like you go up and get a tray, and there are different stations that have different types of food. Then you grab a drink or dessert or side or whatever, and then come up and check out.
Yeah, so getting used to working with a dining plan again is fun. Because, you're like, can I use a quick service on this? And they're like, oh, you get a drink. Oh,
yeah.
Okay. So we'd get a bottle of water.
With our quick service that we get...
So much food.
Yeah, a dessert or a side and a drink. And
and
then we also found out, especially on the last day, that we could break up...
Yeah.
Like a the dining plan into multiple snacks.
Use it in different chunks. Because we had originally got the dining plan where you would get two quick service and a snack a day. But there was some sort of...
promotion at
the time. Yeah, like a promotion. And so our Magic for Less travel agent, Rick Flack, he said, well, for $30 more total, you can get a water view and upgraded to the next level of the dining plan where you get a sit down, a quick service, and a snack a day.
Yeah.
So we got that. So we got the bonus, like, I don't know, it wasn't even a dollar a day probably for the total.
Yeah.
So that was cool. So we didn't feel bad, but we did end up using all of it anyway. With you not feeling good, we managed to get
there. Was some
of
scrambling
it
at the end on the last day that we'll
I think
get
everybody
to.
Does that. But yeah,
our
so
particular
that was
cool. Scrambling.
Yeah, so with him not feeling so good, we did have another ADR that first day. We were going to still try it. But we went to the Magic Kingdom, and it was really rainy.
Yeah, it was, like, off and on raining. Yeah. So we were, like, running in and out of places hiding. So we we spent a while in the Pinocchio Village House.
Mm-hmm. Not eating. We just went in to off our ponchos.
Watching the small world go by and the windows in there. And
yep. Yeah.
So by the when it let up, we ran...
Well, before that, we went to Gaston's Tavern. Cause we,
one of the first times that it rained, we ran to Gaston's.
We had some fast passes. The first fast pass of the day was for the Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, but it was raining, so I didn't want to go on it. And then our second fast pass was for the new Ariel's
ride. Ariel's Grotto.
But instead, we just went and got in line for that.
Right. Instead. Yeah. Most of the fast passes we had picked, we just showed up way too early and said, "Well, do you just want to like go through the line anyways?"
Right. Because I didn't want to be on Seven Dwarfs in the rain. So
right.
So we were like, "Okay, not this." So we went to the second one, and then after we went into Ariel's, that's when we went to Gaston's.
Right. Because it started raining again a little bit, and we ran in there, and I was like, you know what sounds really good? This gigantic cinnamon roll.
Mm-hmm. It did sound really good. But it says warm cinnamon roll. It's not actually a warm cinnamon roll.
Right.
It's a cold, kind of yesterday cinnamon roll. Maybe if you don't go as early as we did.
The friction of the air moving over it as the guy handed it to us, that warmed it up.
No.
An infinitesimal amount.
No, I even wrote on here, not so warm and stale.
If Gaston was there, you could have yelled at him.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, what are you doing with these?
The decor in there is interesting.
What is that? This is a lovely room of death.
Right.
It's just all antlers and animal heads on the wall. It's pretty
funny. I guess the theme works,
right.
But it's kind of gross.
So we sat down for a few and ate a cinnamon roll, and I took a really bad picture of it.
It was too dark.
And then we worked our way around to
the
Pinocchio
Village
House.
Yeah.
And hid it from the rain in there for a little bit. Ran around to Memento Mori and then Haunted Mansion at least once.
Yeah. Because that's my favorite.
Yeah.
Is that your favorite?
And at some point...
Or you just love it because I like it.
I like it a lot, too.
Okay.
I really do. It would be my favorite, probably.
Yeah. I love it.
Out of everything.
I love the theme. Memento Mori is the coolest shop. I want everything in it. Everything.
Because it's all Haunted Mansion.
Oh, it's so great. I want all the dishware.
And so then we circled around to, like, Pirates and Jungle Cruise. And when we got off Jungle Cruise, it was raining.
Again, really
and
hard.
And then it let up, and I remember us coming back over at that point to have lunch.
I think you're right. It's close enough.
Yeah.
So
we ended up at Columbia Harbor House, which is another must eat for us.
Yeah. Always go to Columbia Harbor House. We love it. I like the nautical decor in there. It's really cute. We always get the lighthouse sandwich, which we mentioned, I'm sure, in the first one.
Yeah.
It's a hummus sandwich with
broccoli
slaw. And when we were looking at the menu, we were going to share it. we looked at the menu and it was on some sort of multigrain wheat or something.
Yeah.
That looked like it had seeds all over it. And with Sean's diverticulitis acting up, that's the last thing he needs.
Yeah, so seeds and nuts.
I said, can you get that on white? And she's like, oh, yeah, sure. So we got that, and it came with some chips, and it came with a dessert. So you could get, like, a strawberry thing.
Or chocolate cake.
Or chocolate cake.
And it's chocolate cake.
The chocolate cake was good, though. It was pretty generic, but it was good.
The choice is always chocolate cake.
Chocolate cake was good. And it had little Mickey chips all over
it. And I don't know if it's because we said white bread, but it was, like, four quarters of the sandwich. So it was like two sandwiches.
It was huge. Yeah. It was a lot of food. I don't remember it being that much food.
Yeah, I remember being like two one sandwich. Halves. Right. Yeah, one sandwich. Yeah. So we went upstairs and sat on a little overlook over Memento Mori that's sort of like a ship up there. And it's like looks out either side of the walkway.
Yeah, we like it.
That's the best place to sit.
One side you can see the tangled bathroom, and out the other side,
the palatial bathrooms for Tangled. I don't know
what's the other. Because one side,
the other side looks down Frontier Land.
No, not Frontier.
Adventureland.
Liberty.
Oh yeah, Liberty Square.
Yeah. So one side is Liberty Square, and the other side is Fantasyland, like that where it transitions.
Yeah.
So we like to sit up there. That's our favorite spot.
And then we don't have anything else written down until our dinner reservation.
Yeah, I don't think we got anything else. I think we were full.
Yeah.
So it was nice being able to share a bunch of stuff. So then we went to Hollywood Studios. The rain let up finally.
But it started pouring again as we were walking into Hollywood Studios, and we were fighting to get our ponchos back on in time.
Oh, and we got soaked before we did.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was miserable.
And I didn't want to put the hood up on my poncho because I was pretty sure it was just full of water and it was going to be like a cartoon. Oh, how did 5 gallons of water get in this tiny hood?
Right.
So then we were wet.
Yeah, that was sad.
But then it let up again.
Yeah, and I think the sun came out and it was all right. So, wasn't too late at that point.
Did we do Great Movie Ride first?
Probably.
Yeah.
I love Great Movie Ride.
Yeah, that's another great one.
Yeah, so they
changed
some stuff.
Although it's different now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's got that the Turner Classic Movies introduction and branding.
Was some of the dialogue different?
Yeah, some of it was narrated by what's his name?
Oh yeah, it has a recorded narration now. That's kind of cool.
But they still do the goofy "I'm your host," and now oh no, here comes this mafia guy.
Right, Muggsy or whatever his name is.
Yeah,
so silly. Yeah, I love it. Yeah. I still love it. It's so silly. Yeah, and then we did Star Tours. That was great.
Yeah.
A new Star Tours.
I was a little worried that it was going to throw me around because I also had back problems.
Yeah.
And that's one that says, you know, like if you're pregnant, if you have back problems or neck problems. But
well, it's a good thing you aren't pregnant also.
Right.
That would have been miserable.
Yeah. On top of everything, being pregnant. It would be so typical that I would be pregnant there.
Right?
So obvious.
And then we had reservations at the Sci-Fi Dine-In, which we hadn't been there since the first time we went.
Right.
So that was fun.
So we went and we had vegetarian shepherd's pie, which was the best.
It was amazing.
We took leftovers and I kept those leftovers in the refrigerator in our resort room the entire rest of the trip.
We never got back to it.
Hoping that I was going to have them. But
every time we opened the refrigerator, we're like, oh my God, this smells so good.
These 3-day-old gross leftovers smell so good.
We never got back to them. Oh, they were good. Talk about them.
It was really good. It had, apparently it had fresh vegetables, black beans, and chipotle peppers blended to replicate the pie Mom used to make, topped with mashed potatoes and cheddar cheese.
That was good.
It was really good. It was a little crock of shepherd's pie.
Yeah.
What was it
in, like, just like one of those little, like, mini, yeah, it was like a mini long casseroles?
Dish. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That thing was good.
Yeah. That's what I had, and then Katie had.
I got a burger, and
what kind of burger?
A veggie burger, yeah, black bean.
The Southwest vegetarian burger.
Oh.
With black beans and vegetable patty topped with a warm, house-made tomato jam, arugula, fresh tomatoes, and avocado mayonnaise on a toasted bun with choice of cucumber salad or sweet potato fries.
I got sweet potato fries. But I did not taste much of the avocado mayonnaise.
Yeah,
the tomato jam was too overpowering. Yeah. So it wasn't that bad. Was kind of sad.
I would have eaten yours also.
Oh, and the sweet potato fries, like, I like sweet potato fries, but I don't like them to be sweet. I like them to have their normal sweetness, but then put salt on them and have them be a sweet salty. Yeah. But they had, like, a powdered sugar or something on them, and I didn't like that, so I kept telling him to pick those off.
Right. I had to eat the top layer, the infected layer.
Yeah, so that kind of stunk, because it made them taste not the way I wanted them to. But that was still really good. And then we had dessert.
Right, with the dining plan, we each had a dessert.
Oh, my goodness, yes.
So I had warm glazed donuts with cinnamon apples and topped with vanilla bean ice cream and caramel sauce, and it was amazing, and I ate way too much of it.
Right, even though you didn't feel good.
And I did the thing where you leave, like, one bite, and you're like, I did good.
I didn't eat it
all. I didn't eat the entire thing.
I had a hot fudge sundae. That's all I wanted. Yeah. It was really good, though. Really good.
It was in, like, the big tall glass, mm-hmm. wasn't it?
Yeah, it was in the big tall glass. Oh, didn't we have dessert at Raglan Road? I didn't write down what that was. We shared something.
Uh-oh.
We had some chocolate thing with ice cream and fruit or something. Now I have to look up Raglan Road's desserts.
Well, I'll keep talking.
Okay, you talk about the food.
Well, our server guy was like, he had taken a picture of the couple that was in front of us. The seats there at the drive-in are, like, car-shaped, and there are three booths in each car, and so their kids were in the front in the driver's seat, and the mom and dad were in the middle seat, and then we were in the back when we came in after they were already there. And so he had taken their picture just with an iPhone or something, and we had our new camera, but didn't know how it worked exactly.
We had something set wrong.
He, like, and it's got, you know, the pop-up flash on the side, and so he had his finger over it, so the first, like, three pictures were real out of focus and dark. And then he, you know, he was carrying plates and stuff back and forth, so we got a little, you know, sticky, maybe meat juice or something
on the camera. Oh, I hope not. No, don't say that.
Our camera's not vegetarian
anymore. Probably ice
anymore.
Cream. Sure. It was, like, really, yeah.
But we did get a pretty decent picture.
Yeah. It was
all right. And so what we had at Raglan Road the first night was the chocolate heaven, right?
Yes. Flourless chocolate cake, fresh berries, chocolate ganache, and whipped cream.
Right.
It says it's gluten and dairy free.
I had scraped aside the berries because raspberries and seeds and things.
I think they mean dairy free other than the whipped cream.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
That wouldn't make it
dairy. I guess they just mean the chocolate cake part.
You can eat the chocolate cake.
Yeah. It was good, though.
It was pretty good.
Yeah. So, okay. That's all. I forgot to put that. I guess I should have left that page open so I could write it in here. Mm-hmm. Anyway, so the third day, second day with park tickets, and we ate at Pepper Market again, had our waffles and potatoes, and that was good.
Yep.
And then we went to Epcot.
And let's see, throughout the day, you know, you go to Epcot and you're like, well, what do you want to eat? And I don't know, one of these 5 million choices everywhere, because there's something that sounds awesome everywhere.
And there's lots of little snacky things and vegetarian stuff all over the place.
And so not feeling good and walking around and looking at stuff, but not wanting to look at stuff. And so we ended up in France by the time we got hungry. And they totally changed the France cafe. The little, like, bakery is now, like, half the exit area from the theater.
Mm-hmm.
Probably because that theater doesn't fill up too often too much.
If anyone listened to the last podcast where we were complaining about how tiny that cafe was, they're like, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
It's little not the know. Same.
It's much bigger now. It's got, like, two separate lines, and two sides of the bakery are the same, so you can, you know, queue either way.
Right.
And get the same choices. And it's not just the bakery stuff. They had sandwiches and lunches.
A whole bunch of stuff.
Drinks and coffees and everything. But we ended up with just one chocolate croissant. Is that all we did?
That's all we got.
And they were like, really? This is all you're going to get here? Yep. We have, like, 5,000 French things. You're just going to get a croissant?
We didn't want to eat too much.
We walked in there with our Starbuckses from the morning.
Had we?
Yeah, because I remember walking in with a Starbucks.
Oh, I don't remember that.
And not getting the coffee in the France Pavilion and then thinking, like, you know, ugh, terrible American. drink your Starbucks.
I thought, you keep wiggling the microphone. I hope it's not picking up.
Slowly turning into an Italian vampire accent. Anyways.
Yeah, so.
I still had some coffee, maybe.
I thought we went and got coffee after that.
Maybe we got more coffee.
Maybe. And we sat out by the fountain and ate our croissant.
Yeah.
And then got some photos with the PhotoPass person.
Oh, yeah. Who was in my hand?
Oh, Chip. From Beauty and the Beast. Right. Yeah, because there were Beauty and the Beast topiaries there for Flower and Garden. Flower and Garden didn't start until, like, the day after we left or something.
Yeah.
Something like that. So there were already some stuff. Some topiaries around. All
over, yeah.
Yeah, there were a lot of them. And we could see where they were setting up the food booths, too.
Yeah.
But none of them were
open
when we were there. Excuse me.
So then we circled around for a while past Morocco because we came back there for lunch. Yeah, because we were way over somewhere else. I'm like, I don't.
And then we're like, let's go back to Mexico. Oh, God, no. All right, let's just go to Morocco.
Yeah.
So we went to the Tangerine Cafe.
I had some back and forth there where I was not sure what I felt like eating.
And it was hot. And we were tired already.
Settled on Tangerine Cafe.
But it was really good.
Oh, yeah.
It was really good. I love that place.
We got the vegetarian platter that has hummus, tabbouleh, lentils, falafel. And marinated olives with fresh Moroccan bread.
The tabbouleh, not the tabbouleh, the, I thought there was something else. I thought there was a...
Baba ganoush!
No, it was like, maybe it was the tabbouleh.
It was all good for me.
There was something that was like a bulgur, like the little, was couscous. It was couscous and it had like raisins or something in it. It was sweet. And that was in the middle of it. They don't even mention that.
Yeah. And that's just good to just scoop up a little bit of every portion.
Yeah, it all comes with bread. And you just nom, 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 nom.
And while I was waiting for you, I was sitting outside, and the guy at the table next to me was oblivious on his phone, and this squirrel climbed up and was, like, rooting around in his bag.
I wish I'd seen that.
And then the, like, the wife or whoever came over, and they were like, Fred! Fred! He's looking at them like, what? Pointing at his back. Ah! Get out of here.
That's so great.
Those squirrels do not care.
Yeah. No, yeah. Everything around there is just like, what? Hey, what's right. up? Give me that.
I'm an exhibit. Feed me.
Right,
they're
exactly.
They're standing in front of the sign that says, do not feed the animals. They're blocking it.
Right.
No, it's all cool. It's all cool.
Give me that.
So then we continued back around the lake.
Yeah, we went around a few times.
Yeah, and ended up at the Norway Pavilion, which mostly, a lot of it was closed because they're turning it into frozen land.
Right.
Which they got rid of Maelstrom!
Ah! It's coming back. It'll have Elsa and Anna. And hopefully still some trolls.
Ride. I hope it's the same ride, but they just rebranded it. And at the end, it still has that big Swedish dude, construction dude, the oil rig guy with the flowing mullet.
Right. I love
somehow,
that.
For no reason, I hope that's
it
still
did
there.
Need some updating, though. That stuff was pretty outdated.
Yeah.
It was all, like, late 70s, early 80s beauty.
And everybody just, like, puts their eyes down and does the, like, pass by the
like, don't want to watch Norway your video, movie. Just wanted to ride your ride. Bye!
Yep, I just wanted to do the thing where it's like pirates, but you go backwards down the hill.
I do like that ride, though. I can't remember it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You hit the mic.
I dinged the mic.
Ding-a-dang-donged. But in Norway, we went to, I think we went in there, and then we left went and looked at other stuff, and then we came back, and we got a lufsa.
And I was like, you know what sounds good? A lufsa.
Yeah. But when we had it at the state fair in Minnesota with our friend Jenna, they were warm.
Yeah, like they were just coming off the griddle or whatever they make them on.
And I think that's how they're supposed to be.
I don't know. Well, you mentioned to her. I was like, oh, yeah, we had a lufsa, and it was cold. And she was just like,
she was like, ugh, no.
No.
Right. So I think they're supposed to be warm.
But guess
this
what?
Was, like, cold.
A little crepe type thing rolled up with sweet cinnamon butter inside. Still pretty good.
Yeah.
Hot or cold.
I would have liked it a little more warm. Yeah, you had to say frozen.
I meant, like, even if they made them, you know, that you could pick up at the grocery store and heat up in the microwave. It would still be good.
We should try and make some.
It would still be good.
I wonder if we could get frozen potato pancakes and then slather them with cinnamon sugar butter.
Nah. No, we'll just take a couple random tortillas and...
It'd be just as good.
Yeah, it's just the same thing.
Whatever, same thing. It's like eating...
It's like a churro, but you didn't deep fry it.
Or, sopapillas.
Yeah.
Like eating sopapillas.
Yeah. So we had a little snack there, and then would we end up back at Coronado Springs.
Yeah.
And back at Pepper Market for dinner.
Well, that day was the day that I guess it was the day before. After we finished eating at our ADR at Sci-Fi Drive-In, or Dine-In, sorry. And you were still like, bull about food.
Yeah.
And so I was like, you know what? I'm going to cancel our next ADR. And so I canceled and we just, like, we're just going around. So, not this day when we went back to Coronado, but the next day we were going to Animal Kingdom, and I canceled our dinner ADR at Tusker, and I wish I had immediately made a lunch one, because we were like, oh, we'll just go to Tusker for lunch.
Oh, wait, don't say it, because we got to get to that day first.
Okay, sorry. Yeah.
And now, a word from our sponsors.
What?
Squarespace. You should.
No.
Build it beautiful.
Sean, we're not getting any money for that.
Oh, they don't know that. What if you gotta fake it till you make it, right? We start doing ads for other people's podcasts.
Yeah, we could.
That's squarespace.com/ not VegDisney podcast. So
we went back to Coronado Springs.
And we went to Pepper Market and for dinner this time and not for Mickey waffles.
Mm-hmm.
And we were like, these cheese empanadas sound pretty good. So we had those. They are crisp tortillas filled with Monterey Jack cheese topped with queso fresco and tomatillo salsa.
They would have been good had they been a little warmer.
Sure. Yeah, it was pretty late. It was like 8:30 or something.
Yeah, we did get there kind of late.
Yeah, guess what? Fried pocket full of cheese, still pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe I just have super low standards.
You do like some pretty generic ass shit. Oh, I mean stuff.
Oh, sorry. All right, 32:13, you're going to have to bleep.
All right, let me write that down.
Yep.
Anyway.
You know what? Life's a lot easier when you like generic stuff.
It's true.
You don't have to make advanced dining reservations, but they were pretty good.
They were good.
That's pretty good. And didn't we got a dessert also?
Yes.
It was just like a chocolate cake, and she had to like cut it in half to fit it in the to-go container.
Is that the one we got in the
I think. She, like, chopped it in half. We got that cake twice.
That was good. It was still good.
So, nothing fancy, but it was something different we hadn't had before.
Yep. Yeah, that whole bakery case area had a whole bunch of good-looking stuff in
it. Yeah.
Okay.
Then the next day.
This is day 4, third day in parks.
Back to Pepper Market again, probably like 7.5 hours after our cheese empanadas.
Mm-hmm.
Back for breakfast.
This time I asked them if I could have some potatoes and some eggs, and I got the eggs with the cheese. And those were alright.
And I didn't. I took a bite and I was like, no, I'm not feeling eggs right now.
The eggs were a problem because trying to keep the syrup from getting on them. That was really an issue for me.
I was happy to keep eating Mickey waffles for that day.
Yeah.
And then we headed out to Animal Kingdom, where our drama ensued.
Animal Kingdom was
super
really
crowded.
Sad. It was like, I mean, I've heard stories, or I've heard on podcasts people say that there really aren't any downtimes in the parks anymore, and I think it's true.
For Animal Kingdom, for sure.
Yeah, it was really crowded.
It was really crowded.
Hard to see anything. The animals weren't out really.
Well,
it was too cold.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And a lot of stuff was, like, sectioned off for either refurbishment or for the Avatar stuff going in.
Oh,
I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, almost all of the views, like, on the walkways around the big body of water were covered up.
Right.
Like, there were walls right there.
The bird show wasn't going on.
Right.
Which I liked. And yeah, we didn't even find our favorite little nook over in that Tibetan area over by where the bird
show
was.
We walked past it, but it was full of people.
Was it?
Yeah.
I didn't even see it.
Yeah,
I forgot all about
people
it.
And like a Coke machine or something.
Yeah. So that was kind of depressing for me.
And then we had canceled our reservation at Tusker House, but we went up there like, oh, sure, it's early enough. We can just walk in. And they were like, nope.
Yeah.
That's
that
the drama.
That was depressing, too.
We tried to go for lunch, and they said like, oh, no, we sold out our walk-ins or whatever.
Yeah. That was
so funny. On the way up there, though, we had passed. I've tried to look it up. Like, it doesn't have a name.
It does. It's that Mr. Kamal's.
Mr. Kamal's? Well, I didn't see a name, like, on the menu board or on
the It didn't say it on
hut.
The board. I
it's
had
just
to, I had to find it on the map. And then I looked up that name, and that was what they served. So that's the place.
Okay, cool.
It's between Asia and Africa. It's just a little, like,
random
looks like
hut.
Food cart-ish looking thing.
Mm-hmm.
It just has a sign that doesn't have a name. And it just says, you know, falafel. Samosa, hummus, whatever. Yeah.
So we fell back on that because we walked by it. And I was like, well, falafel and samosa sound pretty good.
Yeah.
And you know what? They really were.
They were great.
It was a really nice
I wish we had gotten
meal.
The hummus, too. Because it was like two snack credits, but we could have gotten all three things for one quick service.
Yeah.
But I didn't know about that or didn't think about it at the time.
Yeah. But it was just, you know, like the little cardboard tray of some falafel with a little cup of tzatziki sauce and then a tray of samosas with some mango salsa.
It was really good. Really good.
Yeah. But we should have gotten the hummus because then we walked up a little farther and we got a Mickey pretzel.
And that was really bad.
It was like one of the last three pretzels that they had and they had no cheese sauce or anything left.
Yeah.
So it was just like cold pretzel.
It was kind of stiff, you know? Like, yeah. I don't know if that's how they normally are.
The first time we
it's
walked by...
It's not a Wetzel's pretzel.
Yeah. You got that right. The first time we walked by, it was still full of, like, pretzels, and, like, they were still at least heating them up. They were spinning around on that little rack.
Mm-hmm.
Had little all kinds of sauces and stuff, but, man, by the time we got back, it was picked over.
Yeah.
I was like, do you want this wholesome fruit or one of our last pretzels? And
right.
I was like, you know me.
Pretzel. I'll take a generic pretzel.
I'll take a pretzel, and I think there's a cheese cup back there that might have fallen on the floor, and it looks like some of the cheese came out, but I'll still take it.
No. That Harambe market that wasn't really open looked really cool, though.
Yeah, that's
all new.
Was a new area, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
There were like three or five.
A whole bunch of
little like
walk-up windows.
Counters, yeah. They were all closed, yeah. But...
Yeah. I can't remember if they had anything we could eat, but it was really cute.
Yeah, there were just a couple things.
It was really cute.
Yeah, I would like to have hung out in that area if it were active.
And if it were nice out. Well, I guess it did get warm. It got really hot.
Right.
Like by the time we were ready to go.
But the whole trip,
tired.
There was like 1 hour where we wore shorts.
Right.
Because we went up to refill our reusable cups or something and came back and we're gonna head out again and we were like, well, by the time we get to where we're going, it's
right.
gonna be cold,
the sun's going down,
put pants back on.
Yep.
That was
but
nice.
We were expecting that. We were expecting it to be mostly chilly.
I packed one pair of shorts.
Me too.
Yeah, didn't actually need them at all though. So then what, we went from Animal Kingdom, we were kind of bummed out, so we went back to Epcot.
Yeah, we went back to Epcot.
Is that when we didn't we go to Boardwalk and then ended up walking to Epcot?
I don't know.
Is that when we did that?
No, I think.
No, because we ended up at Epcot again.
Who
ended
knows?
Up at Epcot every single day.
No, Epcot has a lot to choose from.
Because Epcot's the best. So
Epcot
anyways,
is.
We went from Animal Kingdom. We couldn't tell you how we got there because we had our heads down because we were so sad about Animal Kingdom. We just shuffled into a bus and
where
ended
would
up
it,
at Epcot.
Like, I know a lot of people give Animal Kingdom, like, they'll say, like, it's the least of the four for them or things like that, but we love like going to zoos and we love animals and Animal Kingdom has always been like one of our favorite things, but it was so crowded.
Oh, but we did ride Kilimanjaro Safari and we went to Rafiki's Planet Watch and basically turned around and came back.
Right.
I was just like, this train is a nice excuse to fall asleep for a couple minutes.
Right.
But Kilimanjaro Safari, we got in fast passes on.
Right, which is good because,
and man,
the lines.
That line. There were people complaining because it's, you know, like The sign out front when we came in said 2 hour wait. It's been 2 hours and 45 minutes now.
My right. God. Like, oh my God. And then there's people in the fast pass line with us going, well, they should have gotten a fast pass.
Right.
It really was like
10 minutes is all it took us to get up there and on, I think. Maybe 20 minutes.
Thank goodness we had one. Because
yeah. I wouldn't have waited in that line.
No.
Seeing that counter.
But as it was getting closer to the weekend, it was the fast pass situation was getting to be kind of ridiculous. Like,
yeah. Yeah, you tried to like cash in.
I tried to swap out fast passes to get other fast passes and nothing was available.
Yeah.
And
I was like, here's one at 7:45 p.m. Yeah. Oh, great. Okay.
I guess I wasn't really necessarily that great at going and getting the ticket. And going,
mm-hmm.
But at least when you went and got the ticket, you knew within an hour you were already in that area, and you would just go back and go on the ride.
Yeah.
But getting fast passes like 60 days in advance,
it just seems crazy to me.
You know, and then it rains, or you know, whatever else happens, or you happen to be somewhere else, and everything gets screwed up. And I cannot wrap my head around the whole fast pass situation. I couldn't get it to work really well for us.
And we've been before.
Yeah.
I didn't, and we'll go again. So I didn't necessarily have to like squeeze in every single thing possible.
Yeah.
Especially the way I felt by the time we got there.
I gotta figure out just how to work this whole thing, you know, this whole fast pass thing. Just slow down the whole day. And just be like, okay, we'll just ride it at 3 o'clock. You know, like, whatever. Yeah. I don't care. Because a lot of stuff wasn't available mm-hmm. in the morning. Or we went and just got on something anyway. Yeah. Like, I need to figure out how to do
that
it better.
That whole thing is crazy.
And it started getting really crowded as we got closer to the weekend, too.
Yeah.
We're not used to this type of crowds. Even when we would go and those Brazilian tour groups would be there,
right.
It wasn't that bad. I don't know what was going on. I guess that's how it is now.
It's just busier.
I guess.
Yeah. So then we ran away to Epcot again.
Yep.
And ended up at the Mexico Pavilion with one of the best surprises we had just got. And this was the little, La Cantina mm-hmm. de San Angel. Angel. The little, waterside.
That new waterside place.
Yeah.
So great. Love
and
that place.
I
got a lime on the rocks, which is sort of like a traditional margarita.
Yeah.
It's really good.
And then we just got guacamole with tortilla chips, but it was, for once, it was like the amount of guacamole you would actually want, not the amount you get at like just some, you know, your local Mexican restaurant
or
something.
It was a huge scoop.
Yeah, it was great.
And it was good and fresh. It was good.
Yeah. Yeah, it
was good.
A little
too cilantro-y. Mm. I don't like cilantro. He does, but yeah.
So we sat indoors for that time and, mm-hmm. and looked out the window and stuff and just sat there, and that was really nice.
It would have been nice to sit outside because the birds are just, they're everywhere.
There was one of every species of bird hopping around trying to get dropped.
And they don't care.
Chips.
They're just like, hey, what's up? Can I take that out of your hand?
Hey, this seat was empty. Do you mind?
Do you mind if I sit here with you and eat your food?
I've got my own margarita.
I love the ibis that are all around with their little curvy red beaks.
Yeah.
And they're just like, hey, sup?
Just walking by.
I'm just like a pigeon. What's up?
I'm an employee.
Right?
I'm a janitor.
I'm a cast member.
Yeah.
How are you?
Yeah. So we had that, and then what did we do? Then we ended up getting out of Epcot. This is when we tried to go find Dole Whips.
Oh, yeah.
But
they don't have them at Epcot.
Right.
See, this is why we've never had...
They do for Food and Wine, right? Or Flower and Garden.
I don't know.
The Flower and Wine.
Flower and Wine.
The Food and Garden show. Food and Garden is my favorite time of year.
But yeah, so we're over there. I think we were over there with our... No, we didn't have our Lefses at that point, did we?
No.
We must have been... Okay,
day.
So we're in there with our chips and guac. Looking at the phone.
I was looking at my phone, like, where do you get Dole Whip?
Where do you get Dole
Surely
Whip in Epcot?
One.
No, you don't get Dole Whip in Epcot. Well, right. This is why we never get Dole Whip, because we can't friggin' find it.
Oh, well, there's one at the Polynesian. Well, let's go. And then we end up...
We went into the quick service.
Ended up taking, like, a bus to a monorail?
No, it was a monorail to a monorail.
Okay.
And I I thought Molly was up on your chair.
Oh, no.
No, monorail to a monorail. Over to the Polynesian.
And then we walked all over trying to find where you get a Dole Whip.
Oh,
waited in line at the cafeteria to ask the
guy.
Right,
and then he said it's out and around the corner.
Oh, it's outside around the corner. That's tiny little booth just outside one of the exits from the resort is, what does it say? Pineapple Lanai?
Mm-hmm.
Is that the name of the place? Okay. And so they had, and we had never had Dole Whip before.
Yeah.
So they had the ice cream part.
Just the pineapple ice cream.
The pineapple vanilla twist, and then the thing in the big cup that's like a float or like a slushy. So I still haven't had the Dole Whip. I said, what do people normally get? And she was like, well, they get a pineapple or a twist. And so we had a little bit of both. And I said, give me that twist.
Right. That was really good.
And I ate that on a beach chair on the beach. It was very windy
and
pretty cold. But I was like, I'm on a beach. This is a beach. I'm going to close my eyes. Yep, I've got ice cream. I'm on a beach. I'm on a sun chair. This must be warm.
In jeans and a jacket.
Right.
But there was that little girl in the water.
Yeah.
We're like, is she turning blue?
Yeah.
It was good, though. Mm. But, yeah, we still haven't had the floaty thing.
Yeah. So, and then we walked around the Polynesian again for a little bit. And then
Polynesian's cool.
Yeah.
I like it. We never did make it over there for Tonga Toast.
No.
One of these days.
That's okay. We had it once.
Yeah, I don't remember it. But actually, you had it. I think I got eggs and toast.
Yeah.
So, so we had our
It looks like we
whip.
Ended up back at, back at our resort.
Mm-hmm.
And over in the main, like, pool area that has, like, the big feature at Coronado Springs is that big, like, Mayan-looking temple with the waterfall coming down into the pool.
Yeah, it looks awesome.
And it has a slide. They have, like, a bar and a very little, like, cafeteria counter over there.
Yeah.
And they're right next to the arcade and have, like, the ping pong table and the foosball table.
And, a dig site.
And we got
the
over
kids.
There super late, and for whatever reason, none of the exterior lights were on, so they closed the pool for a while.
Yeah, that was weird.
Because the lights didn't come on, so they couldn't, like, the lifeguards are, like, shooing some people away. And
yeah, that was weird.
Yeah, a weird interaction between the lifeguard staff and
the bar
staff. Almost
because
like
he was all like, "Are you closing?"
Interact
and
with
he was
each
like,
other.
"Yeah, the lights are not." And he was like, "Okay," like all like snotty about it. I was like, "What is happening?"
I don't know. There's some like classism going on
with
cast members.
Stupid pool guy. Stupid bar guy.
It was really interesting.
Yeah, it was weird.
It was almost like peeking behind a curtain.
Right.
So we ended up over there. Fortunately, the lights at the bar were on.
Right.
Just not like the overhead lights. And so we got a caprese roll.
We shared it, didn't we? Yeah, we did.
It was just, caprese, mozzarella, basil, tomato on a ciabatta roll. And it was really good.
It was
good. A really good roll.
And it came with chips. But she was like, you also get a side or a...
Oh, yeah.
Because they
so
didn't
we had
have
French fries.
They didn't have dessert. Oh, did it come with fries?
Didn't we have fries?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Okay, so it came with fries.
And a bag of chips.
But then she was like, you get another thing. And so we got a bag of Lay's.
Yeah.
And took those back to the room with some barbecue sauce later.
Super gourmet.
Yeah, we're high class.
Yep.
So, yeah, that was really good. And I got a margarita. And that was good. Yeah. So.
And that was the end of day four.
Yeah. It was nice. We were just, like, relaxing at that point.
So day five, super mixed. We were throwing you for a loop for breakfast. We did not have Mickey waffles.
We each got egg and cheese croissant sandwiches with hash browns.
With hash browns.
You
and
had
they were
an appetite.
Super good.
They were really good that day.
Yeah, by that morning, I was not feeling a lot better. I still didn't have much of an appetite, but like my guts and stuff had settled down, I guess.
Well, one of the problems
things felt more stable
that happens after he has an episode like this is he's got to change his diet from eating a lot of fiber normally to keep everything moving to
no fiber
at all, so it doesn't aggravate at all.
Yeah.
So then, but then we end up at Disney and it's just like
weird food on top of weird food,
right?
Unexpected stuff, and you're out of town, and
and then you get constipated eating weird food anyway, and then it was just like. On top of what you already had going on.
We already paid the money for these meals, so I'm going to eat them.
Yeah, so it was...
But I was feeling better by that day.
A little bit, yeah. So.
So, yeah, that egg and cheese sandwiches was super good.
They were really good. They look like the ones, like, if you've ever seen those egg and cheese croissant sandwiches that they have at Starbucks, they look identical. I've never had those, but they look exactly like it. And they were, it was really good that day.
And then that's all that we had for breakfast.
Yeah.
We were back at the Magic Kingdom again.
Well, okay, so with the whole Fast Pass thing, not being able to get on rides because either we couldn't get a Fast Pass or the lines were really long and they were out of Fast Passes, so we kept having to go back to the Magic Kingdom to try to get rides in. And that's annoying, because when we would go before, even the very last time we went, which was, you know, what, 5 years ago or whatever, we would go, we'd bust out everything, we'd go to the next park, we'd bust out everything, we'd go to the next park, we could even go, like, Hollywood Studios the same day we went to Animal Kingdom, get everything done, and then just spend the rest of the days just going back and doing whatever. But because it's so crowded now, because I couldn't get Fast Passes or whatever, we kept having to go back just to try and get the one ride.
Yeah. Is that the morning that we booked over there super early and ran straight to Snow White?
Yeah,
and got in the line and and the
it was still long
line. Yeah,
yeah.
Was that the Fast Pass line or no?
I was in the regular line because I couldn't get a Fast Pass.
Right, we just got in the line.
But one thing that's amazing, I didn't have a Fast Pass. I didn't scan my Magic Band anywhere, but they still knew I was on it.
Yeah, they still associated your pictures with...
with our memory maker.
Yeah.
I was like, that's creepy and awesome! So, yeah, so, like, by the end of that day, they had sent me a video like, hey, you were on the My Train! And I'm like, I was!
That video is awesome. It gives you, like, super high-speed slow-mo.
It's a really cool video. Yeah. Like, they, first it's, like, all, like, the promo video, showing the little dwarves and stuff, and then they clip in some ride footage, and then they clip in me on the ride. I was like, that's so cool. That is really cool. But they knew I was on it without me even scanning my band. They still got it.
It must have scanned it somewhere.
It must have grabbed it somehow.
There are scanners in the rides or something.
I wonder.
I don't know.
I think you would have liked that ride had you felt better.
Yeah, I still wasn't sure if I wanted to ride like a roller coaster type ride. It didn't. It seems like it's pretty mild.
It is still fast. Like, I know that you used to do better with roller coasters and you're not as good as you used to be, but like, you still might be like, but it was really smooth.
Yeah.
It looked like it was really a smooth ride.
I stood in the line until it, like, diverted into the queue. Like, this was still all outside the queue, and then I just walked around a few times.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, I hung out by those weird new landscape things they put in where it's, like, a portion of a castle wall.
Oh, yeah,
with, like,
a
spire
in
and, like,
New Fantasyland.
Like, 30 feet of a wall and a couple arches.
Right.
Like, it always looks really weird.
Yeah, that is a weird area.
It's like just evocative of a castle.
Yeah. Is that where that guy took our picture and he told us to make weird faces with the sunglasses?
It was near there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Near there.
I had finally gotten a Minnie Mouse headband or whatever I got. And because I'd been debating it, I wanted to get some mouse ears, but I was like, everything wasn't comfortable. Everything wasn't what I wanted. And I kept looking. Finally got the sequin ones with the big bow.
Yeah.
And some guy was like, one of the PhotoPass guys. He was all like, how'd you find Minnie Mouse's sister? Or something to Sean.
And I was like, I don't know what you mean. Let's take the picture now and then walk away.
But yeah, he had us pose a little weird and the pictures weren't so great. But yeah.
They gotta get bored.
Yeah.
So they didn't mix it up.
Yeah, they're like, I don't know. These two people look like they're kind of annoyed because they had
to
wait in
line forever.
All
right, now you get on the floor. Now you get on his back.
Wait, what?
All right. We're gonna make it look... Here's a whip.
No.
All right. Here, you hold the camera. You take my picture. I'm gonna swipe your Magic Band. You're gonna have a picture of me forever.
That would be funny. Can I take pictures with you?
I probably wouldn't last long as a Disney photographer.
No. That'd be a fun job, though.
Subverting the job would be fun.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, gather around. We're all going to take a selfie. Come on.
So then, since you were feeling a little better, we headed over and went to the Jungle Navigation Company Limited Skipper Canteen. And we walked right in, which I've heard. I've heard that, you know, like, because I think I had heard they weren't taking ADRs, but I think they are now.
Oh.
But yeah, we walked right up because it was like a 11.
Destination like it, like other places.
It was so good. But sadly, I stole Sean's food.
Ah, the heartbreaking food swap of the trip.
I'm sorry.
But we went in and we had, like, you know, you could get a drink too. And normally I would have just said water, but they had a, it's called the Schweitzer Slush, named after the falls. And so I was won over by that. And it had bobas.
Yeah.
It had the little squishy liquid-filled bobas. So.
Yeah.
On top of all the food, I also had a fruity slushy drink.
Right. Schweitzer slush.
That was really good. Oh, geez, you copied, like, everything about that one.
I did.
So I had ordered the curry vegetable crew stew, which is served with roasted acorn squash lentils and sautéed collard greens. Katie had ordered the rice noodle bowl with tofu, which is a pho broth served with jalapenos with a mix of fresh herbs.
But what I didn't realize, I guess once she said, did she say it was a cilantro broth?
I think you said, oh, well, it'll be okay.
I didn't think about how it was a pho, and that is just like, I don't know, Vietnamese food and I... Because they use, like, lemongrass, and they use, like, cilantro, and they use so many things that I have really strong tastes against. I should have known better.
And so she tried mine.
Well, no, I tried mine and was like, ugh.
But then tried mine and was like, oh, this is so good.
Yeah, so I stole his food and gave him. Well, you don't mind cilantro.
I'm not crazy about rice noodle bowl either, though.
Oh, and he ate a jalapeno and about died.
It was red. It didn't look like it was going to be jalapeno-like.
Oh, what was it then, I wonder?
It was some red pepper, but it was super hot and it killed me, and I'll be right back.
You have to go cough? We both got sick after the trip, so you'll have to bear with us. That's why we didn't record before today. We both came down with a cold. He did first, and then I did, and yeah, we're still kind of getting over it, over the sinus-y, oh dear, you all right?
Sorry.
I explained how we had colds.
Oh gosh. So that, curry
whatever
vegetable crew stew would have been super good. I had
really
a couple
good.
Bites and I was like, man, this is really good.
Well, it just makes you want to go back, right?
And then it disappeared. And
let's
then this
go.
Noodle broth crap
oh,
showed up.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I turned it over on the table.
Oh, no.
I didn't.
The decor in there was really awesome.
But then we had desserts.
Oh, I want
to
talk about what it looks like.
Oh, go ahead.
It was really, it was like, we got sat in the animal room, was it?
I think so,
they
yeah.
had, like, the, there were, like, elephants on the rug, and, oh, shoot, why am I coughing, too?
I know, it's because that pepper I talked about.
Yeah, it killed us both again. And, like, on the walls had, like, beams going up that had along the top. Monkeys
oh, yeah.
that were like in the Jungle Cruise ride, like the ones with the pots on their heads.
Yeah.
And they had lamps that looked like parrots, like stained glass parrots.
Yes, they were like stained glass sculpted parrots.
Yeah. And our waitress didn't really make many of the jokes like they do on the Jungle Cruise, but I heard some other servers saying some stuff.
Yeah.
Like there was a one wall of the room had a whole bunch of like china in it, like different platters and stuff like that. And the guy said something to
Here's
them.
Here's
our Great Wall of China.
And I was like, whoa, Great Wall of China. Oh, I get it.
Yes.
Good one.
Really good.
And anytime somebody asked about our food, they would say, safari so good?
Yes.
Yes, so safari so good. And the other room that was connected where the bathrooms were was like set up like a fake bookcase had opened.
Oh, yeah.
And that was the entrance, and I wish we had sat in that room.
I know. Next time we'll have to ask.
They have like a semicircle table booth type thing, and the whole wall of the curve is like pinned butterflies.
Yeah.
In individual frames. That
which
awesome.
May or may not be horrible for vegetarians, but...
That's true.
We're,
I don't care about insects.
Shawn hates insects.
I actually would be kind of creeped out sitting surrounded by butterflies.
Would you?
But it looks really cool.
Like, he won't go into those, like, when the garden places
aviaries
have
and
butterfly exhibits where you can go in. He'd
yeah.
hate those. He's just, tolerated them
I go
me.
In punching. I go in swinging.
No, you don't.
I don't. But I like, if I have a jacket or something, I zip it up and like, you know, shoulders go up. I'm like, no, you're not nesting in my collar, butterfly.
They don't like you that much.
That's what they want to do.
They want to nest
yes.
in your collar.
They also want to move into my ears. Oh. They've got those long proboscises. They just want to reach right in my ears.
They don't.
Ah!
They want nothing to
That's
do with
you.
That's
not a flower.
Your ears.
It's for hearing.
So anyway, dessert.
Yes. The decor is awesome in there.
The decor is awesome. I wish we had gotten some more punny jokes.
We ended up being surrounded by families with kind of whiny kids, though.
Yeah. Because when we got in there, nobody was there.
Nice. Yeah, it started out like posh.
Yeah.
And then it became like Denny's.
Yeah, kind of. We're child-free, so we're always like, oh, God, children.
Yeah.
Sorry if you have children and you love them, but...
Yeah. I mean, why would you take children to Disney World anyway?
Right?
Duh.
Ugh.
The last
Seriously.
Place you want a kid.
No, I'm kidding.
So then we had the dessert menu to choose from.
Oh, but they gave us some bread before that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, like
I
a
didn't
little
like
bread
it.
Service-y type of thing.
I didn't
thing.
Like it. I don't remember what it was.
It was okay. Mm,
It had
an...
Fenugreek? Fenugreek?
No, it...
What was that? Spice. You
look, it
look it up.
Look it up. Do the All thing. Right. Jeez, I wish I could remember anything else about it to talk about while she looks that up. But I can't.
Skipper Canteen bread. Let's see what we can find.
Bread with honey dip. That's right. It had
yeah,
like
but
a
it
honey...
had something in it that I couldn't stand.
Yes, there was something in a spice in the bread that made it... It was a little
bitter.
Sweet on its own, but yeah, bitter.
It had a bitter taste to it.
Bread. Bread.
Bread.
Bread.
Bread.
Bread.
Oh,
scrolling
that
for bread. The
decor is really cool. These pictures. I don't
there's
see
There's the
bread.
Bookcase. There's
yep.
the thing. There's apparently a mystery involved. There's the birds.
Wait, here's
table.
The bread. Okay.
Ambasha
bread. The bread was cool. Honey infused dip.
There's something else. Fenugreek. I think maybe you're right. Maybe you're right.
Doesn't say.
Fennel.
Honey infused dip. Which has a ground mustard texture?
I don't remember that. Scroll down a little. There's a picture right there. I don't think we got that one. Cross section of the ambasha bread. If you could only see this, you'd understand exactly what we're talking about.
Well, anyway, it had a, like a, it was sweet. The sweet was good. The bread was good. But then there was an aftertaste of the honey dip that was just like...
That made you want to get all the honey on the bread and then throw it up and stick it to the ceiling so it was
no,
out of sight.
Not quite.
So on top of all that, then we had to pick dessert.
Yes. Where's my list again?
And they had like... this was the one where it was like individual... It was like three little
No,
desserts.
That was the wave. That
I
was
thought
late.
This one was.
Uh-uh.
What was this one? Let me
I got the Kungaloosh. You got the coconut bar.
Oh, right. It was a little bar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So his was the coconut bar with pineapple basil compote and vanilla cream.
It was exactly something I would like and totally something Katie would not like.
It was fine. I didn't want yours. I wanted mine. But I got the Kungaloosh, which I know is based on a drink from the Adventurers Club. Which is before my time, but I've heard about it on podcasts. But it was a chocolate cake with caramelized bananas served with cashew caramel ice cream topped with coffee dust.
But the coffee dust was just
I couldn't taste it.
Yeah, there was no, like, coffee flavor.
It wasn't strong.
It was just for being fancy. It was for adding a few more words to the menu.
Right.
Ooh, well, coffee does.
It might have been a little something, and I just didn't pick up on it because there was too much going on. But I liked it all except the banana. Like, I tried it with the banana, wasn't into the banana. Like,
yeah, caramelized banana. I ate those.
You ate that, yeah.
I put it over here with my coconut crap.
It was really good. Yeah, coconut banana crap.
It was good.
Yeah, it was really good.
And then we hobbled out of there. Let's go do some more of this magic sorcerer stuff.
Is that the day we were doing that?
Yeah.
Yeah, so we were playing that card game. And then is that the day we also saw somebody playing that other game and went and found out about
that? Maybe. Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Someone else was doing one of the Pirates of the Caribbean games where you run around and...
with the treasure map.
Yeah. And we were like, well, this isn't even this sorcerer game. What is this game?
And she was like, oh, you go over to this little booth over by this, and they give you a map, and then you go around and you do the thing.
So we did a few of those.
Yeah. We liked Kim Possible when we were there, and so we were excited to play some other
games
like
that. I didn't want to do the Phineas and Ferb thing, because it all looked like the same gimmicks were going to happen.
Oh, yeah.
Just with a different old cell phone this time.
That cell phone looked a lot better than the other cell phone we had, which was like a flip phone.
Right.
When we did
But
Kim
it was
Possible.
A flip phone that went doot-doot-doot-doot.
That's true. What's the sitch?
So then we did that around Magic Kingdom for a while. We went to the first aid room and got some acetaminophen for my head because I had a super huge headache that day.
I had heard on some other podcast that you could go to the first aid and they would give you stuff, like, for free.
I heard they have a room with a bed and you can lay down for a while.
I don't know if it's right there. It might be somewhere else.
I should have just said, like, I'm in emergency need of a nap. These benches out front aren't cutting it.
Yeah, Sean wasn't feeling so good.
Yeah.
You had a super headache.
So then, surprise.
It's because I took your lunch. I'm so sorry.
Jerk. That noodle bowl was full of headache.
Oh, no.
I ate too much of it. It could have been from the pepper now that
It could have given you a headache.
It went straight to my head.
Sinus pain.
So then, it's a big surprise, we ended up at Epcot again.
We were going to go to Sunshine Seasons and get the vegan korma.
Right, but they were closed by the time we got back over there.
Yeah, since Soarin' is closed and everything, like, the hours there are, like, bizarre.
And the,
it was only, like, 7 o'clock.
The Timon and Pumbaa thing is closed, too.
I think that's permanently closed.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I think they closed that permanently.
Oops.
The Circle of Life thing, yeah.
Yeah, but Mickey was there at the other restaurant.
Oh, what is that?
The one that overlooks Living with the
Land. Garden Grill?
Sure.
The one that's...
It rotates?
Yeah, it rotates really slowly.
Slowly?
Yeah,
it rotates so slowly you can't tell that it's rotating.
I want to eat there sometime if they have something we can eat.
But then we went downstairs and I was like, all of their menu screens are turned off.
Right.
They're not serving anything else.
So then we booked it out of there and went back to the Electric Umbrella because they had a veggie non-witch. And I think we shared that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which was okay.
It was good. I thought it was all right. It was like they took the coleslaw from the lighthouse sandwiches at Columbia Harbor House and stuck them in there with some edamame.
Was it almost like a broccoli slaw, edamame, and tofu wasabi dressing with a choice of grapes or french fries?
It totally was.
I thought so.
And we got fries.
Yeah. We had french fries and then a little strawberry cheesecake this time because... they were like, you want the chocolate cake, right? And we were like, normally, yes. But today, no.
The strawberry cheesecake didn't look like it had seeds in it.
Yeah.
Which is one of the things we watch out for Sean.
And it was good.
Yeah, it was good.
It was pretty good. We sat in there for a while and then left again. We also wanted to take pictures of the light up floor.
Oh, yeah.
Or at least just play around on the light up floors.
Yeah. And were we going to try to ride Spaceship Earth again and it didn't, like, the line was too long? I can't remember.
I don't think we were going to try, but we walked past it.
The one time we did ride it, their thing didn't work and we couldn't get our video off of it.
Yeah. And we stopped inside again.
Hmm?
We got stopped inside.
Oh.
This time it was by the printing press.
Yeah.
So it
every
didn't
time.
Smell like fake burning wood like the last time we got stopped inside.
Where we got stopped by the Roman thing the last time we got.
Call it the first backup system. Or no, that's the World Wide Web part.
Oh, yeah. Sean's got it memorized.
Dame Judi Dench. Tell me about anything. Tell me about this spaceship that we're all traveling on together.
Yep.
So what was that? That was the end of the day?
Yeah. Then I guess we went back to the room and died.
We rolled ourselves back for day 6.
Yep. This is the last day we had at the park. The last day before we were leaving early the next morning.
Yeah.
So we went to the pepper market and we shared an egg and cheese, I think. But it wasn't as good.
It's because we were over the initial shock of having it and how good it was.
It wasn't as good.
All right. Sorry? You're looking at me like, like some impossible truth has been revealed to you about the world.
And then we ran back to Epcot and made it in there for Sunshine Seasons vegan korma.
Because
and
we were determined to have the vegan korma.
I don't think you felt good that day.
Yeah, I was feeling not great again.
Yeah.
But the vegan korma was pretty good, and we hung out next to some English couple.
Yeah, with their
kids. Said adorable things to their kids.
Yeah, the lady was English. I think the dude wasn't.
Oh.
But yeah, they were pretty cute. They were cute. Were they talking about going to see...
I don't remember.
Oh, they were cute. So that was... Yeah, that was fun.
We wanted the korma because it has Gardein meatless chicken in it.
And we got a whoopie pie.
Oh, yeah.
We were like, what desserts do we get with the dining plan? She's like, any of these. And
right.
We're like...
Well, then I'm having a whoopie pie.
So we got a whoopie pie. We were sharing that day.
What was the whoopie pie?
It
I can't
was like,
remember now.
It was like two, like maybe they took like a cupcake type of thing that was red velvet, and then they cut it, and they put ice cream or something.
Cream something?
Some whipped thing in the between.
Yeah, it was
and
red velvety.
Then they had frosting on top and a little Mickey. A little Mickey face.
Yeah.
Chip, a little Mickey face
chocolate.
Oh, yeah,
chocolate. Like a cookie wafer.
Yeah, it was really cute.
Yeah.
It was good.
That was good. I enjoyed eating his head.
Yeah, it was good. So we shared that, and it came with rice, and it was really mild.
Yeah.
It, like, didn't have a whole lot of flavor to it.
Yeah.
But it was good.
It was cool having Gardein there.
Yeah.
Glad they incorporated that.
Mm-hmm. And then...
Is that the day that we rode Ellen...
Maybe.
We rode Ellen. I rode her.
Yeah, maybe. We were thinking about the Ellen's universe of energy, and we're like,
the only thing I remember
is dinosaurs.
Yeah, some of the dinosaurs.
And now we know why. It's the only thing.
The majority of what you see in that is just dinosaurs, and then her on Jeopardy.
Right. Yeah, that ride
is Jamie Lee Curtis.
Right. It's so weird.
And everyone's so young.
Yeah, I know.
It must have been like 96 or something.
The funniest part was when she's sitting on the sofa and her neighbor Bill Nye, the science guy, comes in and that cat sitting on the chair with his ears back like the whole time.
Next time you're there, watch the cat.
Watch the cat.
Yeah, so that was all we had for lunch.
Yep.
And then we ended up on another like...
Oh.
We ended up on a bus to a ferry... To a monorail and then back to a ferry or something.
We were having transportation issues that trip.
We took all the transportation. At one point, we ended up on the balloon at Disney Springs. And we were like, how did we get up here?
No, this doesn't
even go anywhere but up.
We did not.
But ultimately, we ended up at the Wave.
We
for
were gonna,
our reservation.
Was it that time when we were like, oh no, it was afterwards? At some point, we were like, we'll take this monorail, and then we'll get off at blah, 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 and we'll take another monorail, and we'll go to da, da, da. But no, it did, like, we ended up all sorts of crazy places.
Mm-hmm.
Had to get back on monorails.
Up in that balloon.
No.
And then down. Yeah.
But anyway, we wound up at the wave. A ferry to the Magic Kingdom, and then walked over.
Oh, yeah, we walked very fast because I thought we were going to be late.
Yeah, we thought we were going to be late for our ADR. at the wave, and the wave. So I thought I remembered it being up on the top floor, but it was on the bottom floor.
Yeah.
And because I thought I remembered a bunch of windows.
Yeah, me too.
We'd only eaten there the first time we went, which was, you know, 5 years ago. But it was one of those things where it's like, do you have a phone number and we'll text you when your table's ready? And it was like 2 seconds later they text me. And I'm just like, well, that was a waste of a text. What was that about?
So just that yell the phone number.
Right. So that was interesting.
And then we sat there for like 15 minutes.
Wondering why nobody was asking us for a drink
order. And the server came over and was like, have you been helped yet?
And I was like, no, he was walking by and I said, excuse me.
Oh,
could you find out who our server is? And he goes, oh, I think it's me. He was so embarrassed.
Thanks, dude.
Yeah, but he was fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what did I get? I got the pan-seared tofu with cilantro pesto and succotash, which Sean was able to get without the corn.
Yeah.
And Katie had curry vegetarian stew with jasmine rice, for which she was given mixed wild rice instead, but it was still good.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're just reading our comments instead of relating them.
I'm going to post all this later on the blog.
Okay.
But,
yeah, mine was good. It was kind of simple and, you know,
I would have hated
a bowl of stuff.
I would have hated it.
A bowl of stuff with tofu and
the tofu
curry,
was good.
Or cilantro pesto.
The cilantro pesto was disgusting.
Mm. Blah. Disgustingly delicious.
No, I hate cilantro.
And your vegetarian stew was good.
The vegetarian stew was really good. It was similar, sort of, to the thing I got at Skipper Canteen.
Yeah, it was really similar.
It had a similarity to it. It was sort of like a curry, I guess like an Indian thing, but it was really good.
And they also brought out bread, which I was excited about, except that it was bread held together by nuts and seeds.
Yeah, he couldn't get any piece apart that didn't have nuts in it.
I was just trying to pull it apart and it didn't work. So I think I just maybe ate a little bit of butter.
Right. And it came with
I'm going to eat this butter.
It came with like Himalayan salted butter or something.
Yeah.
That was so goofy.
Just
it was
like
just
a pat of butter with some salt on
it. It was a big slab of cold butter with giant pieces of reddish salt on it.
Yeah.
That didn't taste like anything unless you managed to get it together, and then just tasted like salted butter.
Himalayan mountain rock salt, please.
Taken,
not just salt.
Taken from the toes of Yetis.
It's a delicacy in country.
But yeah.
And then we had dessert there, which was like a 3-course dessert.
Oh,
of
man,
little samples.
That dessert. Yeah. I got the chocolate one, which was like chocolate flight. German chocolate cake with salted caramel, chocolate ganache, and toasted coconut chocolate creme brulee with fresh raspberries.
Oh, that
and a chocolate brownie with white chocolate ice cream and Godiva chocolate sauce. The chocolate cake, the German chocolate cake was gross.
Yeah, that was for me.
Yeah. But the rest of it was really good.
Yeah, the creme brulee, it was like crunching through a frozen pond
of chocolate.
Of like molten brownie.
Yeah,
which I guess, I don't know if that's what creme brulee is.
I guess so. That's good. And
it's
what
not
did you
the
get?
Thing that's on fire. I got the American Flavors Flight. It was a coconut panna cotta with passion fruit drizzle and passion fruit bobas, which are basically the same bobas that I had in my drink.
Right.
That was good. A s'mores graham cracker cake with house-made toasted smoky marshmallow, gluten-friendly carrot cake with cream cheese mousse, and rum roasted pineapple. And guess what? It was all really good.
It was
like a s'more. It was like a fancy s'more. And then some carrot cake with some pineapple on it.
I didn't like your coconut thing. I'm not crazy about coconut. But the rest of your stuff was good.
And they were all small enough that you were like, oh, good, I can eat this. And then eat some more of this one. And then eat this one. And come back for a little bit more of this one. And I have a little bit of yours, too, while you're not looking.
Oh, and then did you get some fancy drink? Didn't you get some weird drink?
There What did I get?
I thought you got some
drink. I just got a Diet Coke.
Did you?
Yeah, it was a Coke, but it was a Diet Coke.
Ooh, fancy.
Why? What are you remembering?
Well, because my water.
Oh, right.
So then I was like, I'll just have some water. And he's like, oh, well, do you want one of these bottled water? Because it was, yeah, it was included in the thing. You get a drink. And I was just like, yeah, sure. And I'm thinking, I'll just take it with me.
Right.
And we'll drink it, you know, at the park or, you know, whatever. Yeah. And he brings out this giant glass bottle of water that's like a wine glass size, a wine bottle size, with a fancy wine glass.
Yeah. And he poured it into the wine
water. And I'm like, it's friggin' water. It was hilarious.
I mean, it was tasted.
It did
just
taste better.
Like water.
It tasted better than the water that they gave us at the table, but yeah.
Yeah, than the tap water from the Seven Seas Lagoon.
Right.
Right. Is where all the tap water comes from at Disney World.
Oh man, yeah, that the water he brought when we just asked for water wasn't very good, but this water, ooh.
Yeah, Evian. I mean,
but yeah, I wasn't taking that with us.
Right. I took a couple of my vitamins with it, and it was the best those vitamins ever tasted.
Oh, I'll bet.
Not really.
He also said since it was our anniversary, he gave us champagne.
Oh right.
Yeah. That was good.
Champagne.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that was good.
And then we probably took a monorail to a bus and then a train. We ended up on the Magic Kingdom train. We were like, how did we even get here?
I think we walked back. No, what did we do? No, we did take a monorail. Oh, I remember. We were going to go and see the fireworks at Hollywood Studios.
Right. Yes. And by the time we got there,
we realized
they had started.
Right.
And I was like, oh no, if we get off and watch these, we're going to be here for like 3 hours.
Yeah, trying to get back.
So we just got on the next
bus. And we had to get up early the next day and we still hadn't packed.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we were just like, we got off at Hollywood Studios, which took forever to get to. And we were just like, all right, where's the bus to our resort?
Yep.
Turned right around, went home. That sucked. Yeah, that sucked. But I did. I wanted to see those fireworks, so we'll have to see them sometime. I hear they're really good.
So then we got back, and we were like, that it was 8:30 or something, and realized like, wait, we have to leave so early that Pepper Market's not going to be open to have breakfast.
Right.
So we ran up to Pepper Market. Was already closed, wasn't it? Or it was just
no. I think they were just serving dinner.
Right.
Stuff.
Like, how are we gonna heat it up or take it or anything? So we went to the Cafe Ritz, which is next to the like gift shop area, which is weird to have like the Cafe Ritz attached to Ritz Lounge right across, like 3 feet away from Pepper Market. It's like they just jammed all the food places together.
It was nice though, having all those. We should have gone in that bar at one point. I think they had food.
Yeah.
I didn't remember.
The Cafe Ritz was just sort of like a
quick
really
mart,
small
quickie mart with some pastries.
Yeah. So we grabbed a couple cheese danishes to have for breakfast. And we were like, man,
and some
orange
juices.
We got all these things left. We got to break up and have snacks. So we got a couple orange juices. We got
water.
Yeah, another water. Which
and some treats.
I didn't think about not being able
to take it past.
I didn't think about the water being more than 3 ounces of liquid. So the guy was just, I'm throw this right away.
Yeah, that sucked.
At the airport. Did we get anything else? Did we get, like, a bag of chips or anything?
We got a bunch of... We used, like...
Oh, we got 3 Mickey Rice Krispie treats.
Yeah.
Which I just finished the last one 2 days ago.
We don't normally eat gelatin, but we just did.
We just did.
You know what? But I ate the one. Oh, you okay?
Yeah.
I ate the one when we were, because we got one that was chocolate, and we got 2 that were regular, and they didn't really agree with me, so I think it was probably because I just felt like, this has gelatin in it. He's off coughing. But yeah.
Sorry.
That's alright. And what other snacks did we get? Because we did have a Mickey ice cream bar at some point.
Oh, yeah. We finally had a Mickey ice cream bar.
We'd never had one of those.
Yep.
We had a Dole Whip.
We had Rice Krispie Mickeys.
Yeah.
We had pretzel Mickey.
Yeah.
I ate a Mickey-shaped cookie wafer.
Mm-hmm.
What other characters did we eat?
I think that's it.
Yeah. The other characters don't get, you know, like, the treatment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like Mickey does. Because it's really easy. It's just a big flat, three circles.
Yeah. So, I had fun, but it felt like, I don't know.
And then we flew away.
Yeah. Did you have a good time, even though you didn't feel good?
Yeah. As good a time as I could, not feeling like that and dealing with that stuff. Yeah.
So, we're trying to figure, because we're really careful with what he eats, like seeds and stuff. But it still happens sometimes, so we're trying to figure out why and whether or not it's a stress issue.
Yeah. So yeah, some people say, you know, like my mom has it, and she developed it from eating a ton of popcorn, but now she's back to the point where she can just eat popcorn again.
Is she really?
Yeah. Yeah, she just eats some popcorn.
I don't think she has it as bad as you, though, right. Even when she does have it.
Right.
I don't think she's like...
Because there's
I gave 9 pints of blood in one sitting.
A lot of people say, you know, nuts and seeds are fine. Mm. Some people say, you know, it's not good. Some people say this is good and that's bad. And
right.
It's all...
Because you don't eat corn. You don't eat popcorn. We cut the seeds out of cucumbers and tomatoes and things like that.
I just look at an eggplant and laugh.
Right. That one time we ate an eggplant and you about died. We weren't thinking about it. Yeah.
Yeah.
So we're really careful, and it still happens.
Something set it off, yeah.
So it may be stress. So my cure for that is we'll just go all the time.
Yeah.
And you'll get so used to it. Nature, it's just like, well, yeah, we're going to Disney again.
Might as well move down there.
Okay.
Let's just go.
All right.
With our Squarespace money.
What? Wait, what? What's Squarespace?
Squarespace.com/notvegDisney.
We don't have a... If anybody wants
build
to...
Build it beautiful.
If anybody wants to sponsor our podcast. But
we're taking applications.
So, I set up a Facebook page since the last time we recorded. It's VegDisney on Facebook.
And you might be listening to this on YouTube.
Yeah, I need
I
to put it up on YouTube.
I just suggested, why don't we just throw this up on YouTube also?
Yeah, I should. And VegDisney.com. I bought the URL, and it goes to our other site, a subdomain. And
of Game Love.
Yeah, we have
this podcast brought to you by GameLove.com.
Yeah, there you
go. I can say that.
Yeah, GameLuv.
Yeah, if you're also into video games,
which we are,
come check out all my random ramblings.
Mm-hmm. So, anything else? I think that's
it
for now.
No, I think that covers it. What did we eat on the plane? I got some little Biscoff cracker cookies,
mm-hmm.
a bag of chips or something.
Oh, we've at
that's not really Disney.
At Atlanta, we had those little crepe things that you hated.
We came
and
back
I liked.
To real food.
Yeah,
airport food.
Had to pay real money for it.
Yeah, it was like $16 for 2 crepes.
Yeah,
full of just like hot wet cheese and tomato.
Yep.
It's leaky all over the place.
Yep.
We had to scarf it down and then get on a plane again.
Yep. Oh, well.
Welcome back to reality. And then we got colds.
Yeah.
Almost as soon as we got back.
Yes. That was miserable.
And it didn't record this for 2 weeks because we were still getting over them. I got it first. Then you developed it.
Mm-hmm. I was a couple days behind.
Yeah.
I got a super fever. At least
so that's
didn't
where
get that.
The coughing and stuff mm-hmm. is still coming from.
Yep. Okay. Well.
All right.
Thanks for listening. Hopefully we'll record another one about whatever. I don't even know. We'll have to go down again.
We'll just get some like headlines together or something.
Okay.
Maybe.
Yeah. So visit us on Facebook. We'll
like,
talk
follow,
about
subscribe, comment, right heart, click a heart, click a like, click a little lightning bolt. Don't click an X. Subscribe to an RSS feed. Submit us for a Webby Award.
What?
The best of Facebook list. Add us. Reshare. Retweet. Reblog. Re. All the way home. Squarespace.com.
I don't know him.
I have a hard time letting go. I have a hard time ending things.
Yeah. Okay. Well, thanks for listening.
Yeah. Thank you for listening.
Talk to you later.
Yep.
Bye.